transition. Okay. So to design this particular transition, we need to draw we need to draw one rectangle which has a size of the WR90 waveguide. You can see this is a rectangle with 22.86 mm, and this is a size 10.16 mm. That is the standard dimensions of the WR90 waveguide. I have drawn one rectangle. At some distance, I need to give a specific length. Okay. At some distance, and this length should be, you can say, larger than a guided wavelength of TE10 mode. Okay. This length should be larger than a guided wavelength of TE10 mode. Okay. So this length I have decided, and the length you can see, it's almost mm. You can say it's 50 mm, more than 30 mm. Yes, correct, because to satisfy the lambda g guided wavelength criteria, the length or distance between these two is 50 mm. Okay, now to create 3D object from the 2D two 2D objects which are in the same plane. Okay, remember our first session of geometrical modeling. If we want to create a 3D object from two 2D objects which are lying in the same plane, okay, we need to use a command called select both the objects, right click, edit, surface, connect. Once you click, it will connect these two objects linearly. It will connect these two objects linearly. Okay. So this way you can create a rectangle to circular transition. Okay. Correct. But the condition is, cannot simulate this transition directly. You cannot simulate this transition directly. Okay. Because once you assign the viewport on this face, okay, suppose you are assigning the viewport at this particular face, it will not generate pure TE10 mode. It will not generate pure TE10 mode because there is a immediate discontinuity in the waveguide. It's not maintaining proper rectangle shape to generate TE10 mode and to get it matured. Okay, there is a immediate discontinuity after this rectangle phase. It's not longer rectangle, pure rectangle. Okay, same way on the other side, at this particular phase, the TE11 mode is not matured. It's just generated. It's not properly propagating. Okay. The mode to propagate properly, we need to have at least lambda by 2, or you can say lambda g by 2 length of the waveguide for that particular mode. Then only that particular mode will generate, get maturity, and start propagating properly. So that's why.
Sir, please repeat the lambda g concept, sir.
Okay, so that's why I have given a proper rectangle waveguide before the transition and the proper circular waveguide after the transition. Okay. I have not simulating only this particular transition. So you can see this land is the lambda g, a guided wavelength which is depends on your operating frequency and the cutoff frequency for that dedicated mode. Okay, so you can say lambda g is equals to lambda zero operating frequency or operating wavelength upon under root 1 minus lambda zero by lambda c whole square.
Yeah, boys.
That is lambda g. Okay. That is lambda g. To have a proper length of the, or you can say uniform cross section, we need to maintain. That we are maintaining. This is my rectangle waveguide, this is my transition, and this is my circular waveguide. Okay. I am not simulating only transitions, I am simulating an entire system. Rectangle, transition, and the circular. Okay. To get a proper TE10 mode to TE11 mode conversion transformation. Okay. So the practical transitions, if you want some narrow band, you can use this simple linear transition. If you want some broad banding, you can have a transition. You can say sinusoidal shape, exponential shape, different profiles of the transitions are available, and that you can design using equation based curve. Okay, you need to follow the same fundamental, but you can use equation based curve to design a different. Now let me show you. You can see this is my waveport number one, which is generating TE10 mode. This is my waveport number two, which is generating TE11 mode. Okay, and let me show you the modes. You can see this. I am getting a transformation. This is my S11 port one mode one. This is my S21, that is port 2 mode 1. The port 2 mode 1 is TE11, port 1 mode 1 is TE10. So I am getting almost 0.9983. Almost all from TE10 mode to TE11 mode is getting transferred. Okay, almost all the powers from TE10 mode to TE11 mode is getting transferred. Apart from this, you can see the electric field. At the input, we have a TE10 mode. At the output, it's TE11. TE11 mode. So input is TE10, output is TE11. Okay. And there is a transformation from TE10 to TE11 through this transition. Okay. So this is a basic rectangle to circular waveguide transitions. Without this, it's not possible to design a more practical conical shape horn antennas. We need to use this particular transitions always to make it more practical simulation. Okay. So you can see that we are transferring X polarized. You can see the polarization X polarized. This wave is X polarized. Polarized electric field is along X axis. So X polarized TE10 mode getting transferred to X polarized TE11 mode. The polarization is not changing. Okay, we are maintaining the continuity in the polarization. That is also very important to maintain the continuity. Okay. So this is my rectangle to circular waveguide transition. Okay. Apart from this, Let me discuss.
Sir, please explain how to give the analyze setup to the this waveguide, to the rectangular waveguide or circular waveguide.
Hey, yesterday we have discussed. It's very simple. Means we have drawn the waveguide. Okay, we have drawn the waveguides. This is my rectangular waveguide. This is my circular waveguides. Okay. And I am assigning the waveports at the input and the output. You can see the two waveports. Okay.
This is the magic tape.
So we need to assign the waveports at the input and output of the circular waveguide, and you can analyze the circular waveguides through that.
Sir, so, we are sir, please have assigned the waveport, but how to assign the setup, analyze setup to this waveguide?
Yeah, guys, you need to assign only, you can say, frequency or which frequency you want to simulate. Okay.
Please explain that step.
Yeah, just you need to right click on the analysis. Okay, once you right click on the analysis, it will ask you for the frequency. Okay, you need to give a frequency at which frequency you want to do simulation. That's it. And let it be this conversion criteria 0.22. There is no need to change the conversion criteria this maximum delta as at the initial stage. Okay. And maximum number of passes you can change. Maximum number of passes you can change by default 6 to 10. Okay.
If it is wrong,
the number of passes means.
Hello.
The number of passes means.
Number of passes means it will do an adaptive meshing from pass 1 to, you can say, pass 6. To get criteria 0.02. Okay. It will do an adaptive meshing. So pass 1, pass 2, pass 3, pass 4, until it will do the simulations until your convergence criteria will be satisfied. Okay. You can see that. So I have simulated for 2 passes because my conversion is achieved within 2 passes. Okay, so pass 1.